This video will be interesting as this is the first time we will be exploiting a machine. Whenever we approach a machine, the first thing to do is to reverse engineer and understand what it does. Then we look at its mitigations and try to find where the buggy code is in the program. Binary exploitation is nothing but the exploitation of binaries with the help of vulnerable code written due to carelessness of a developer. We usually use the vulnerable piece of code to make the program do what we want rather than what it should be doing. So first, I assume that you are using a Linux operating system or using a virtual machine that has Linux. If you don't have Linux, then I would want you to install Ubuntu as it's user-friendly and good for binary exploitation. Now let us see about PawnTools, which is an amazing library in Python that can interact with the server and the binaries. Throughout the videos, I'll be using Python with PawnTools. To install PawnTools, go to your terminal by Ctrl-Alt-T and type pip install PawnTools. Now you're good to go. Whenever you have doubts regarding the commands, go to their official documentation, which is also given below in the description. So I have a simple vulnerable binary, which we will exploit. We will try to break this binary and get a shell. You can think of shell as a way to talk to everything in a system. A shell is of no use in a local machine, but imagine if this binary was hosted in a server and you find a way to get a shell. Then that gives you permissions to change, edit, and delete anything on a particular server. As the first step, let us see what file this is. Using file 1, we can see its specifications. Here we see the binary is 64-bit compiled, which means registers will be 64 bits. Next, we see it's dynamically linked, which means the binary will be linked to an external library that will be used when the program needs certain functions like printf and scanf during runtime. Next, it says the binary is not stripped, which will make a decompiling work easier. We are at the last step. Now let us learn the different mitigations of a binary. For this, sudo apt install checksec and use this tool to gather the information and mitigations of the binary. First, we see RELRO, which is relocation read-only memory. The full RELRO security measure makes the binary secure from a GOT overwrite, which we will cover later. Next, we see the canary, which is a secret code which is on the stack. It will make sure that the attacker cannot jump or return to another program using a buffer overflow. In this case, when an attacker tries to overwrite the RIP, a memory compare will be done to the canary. So if the canary is changed, then the program will exit, else it will continue. In later videos, we'll be seeing how we brute force canary. PIE, which stands for Position Independent Executable, which shifts the location of the binary every time it's run. Let's read the rest and continue. Let us reverse the binary. PD main to disassemble main. Here we see a new function called gets. So let us check that out with man gets, which will open the manual for gets. We can understand that it will get a string from the user like scanf. We can go down below in the bug section. It says gets will continue to store characters past the end of the buffer. It is extremely dangerous to use. So in this case, developer of this program was careless and used the get function in his program. Knowing that, we can move further to the program. We see there's a compare statement between RBP-OX4 and OX539. If it is equal, then it outputs good job. Else there is a flag. So a flag is a string that has a value in game called CTFs. Now you will have a doubt, we already got the flag, then why do we need to have this or exploit this? I told you at the beginning that getting a shell or exploiting things in your local machine will not help you. But rather, if the binary was hosted in a server, then we would have gotten the flags. And this could have been a placeholder. Okay, now let us understand the concept of buffer overflows. So when you have access to arbitrary write to a buffer, then we can try to get hold of the return pointer by filling up like this. Let's say B has the arbitrary write and we need to change A, that is OX539, to something else. This can be done by passing a string of length more than the buffer size of B. So now we understand this. Now let us try to use pwn tools library to interact with the binary. So we will first import the library by from pwn tools import everything. This asterisk represents everything. Now let us create a process that will let us interact with the binary we need to exploit. In this case, it's vuln. So we create p as our process to vuln. Now let us send a string to the binary with arbitrary length. With the sendLine command, you can give the binary what you want. And then we know the program will send the flag. So let us receive it with receiveLine. Now run this Python script. Amazing. We leaked the flag. So we understood that in the stack, the buffer, as it could not store more than 10 bytes, it flooded the stack with the remaining string, thereby changing the value of the target. So I created another program similar to this where we have to jump to another function. So let us decompile the main of this binary as usual and then check for its mitigations. The mitigations have not changed much, but let us try to see the bug. This time also, we get the bug. So let us try to exploit this. But wait, we don't have a variable to overwrite. Now let us try to see all the functions in the binary with info func. Nice. We see there is a win function. Yep, it is our flag. So we have to jump to this function using gets. Exactly. If you remember from the first video, we know that main is called from libc start main. So the address of exit will be pushed onto the stack before calling main. So we can override that address to the win function. Then we can shoot out the flag. So let us do it. Let us try to find the offset by setting a breakpoint at the return in the main function. And then running a program with a repeated pattern like this. Now, why a repeated pattern? We do a repeating pattern to identify the offset till we need to write the jump. So now run the program with the pattern. We can see that our RSP has been modified to a specific set of characters. So in this case, it was CC and 6 Ds. After that, we have to pass our win function. So let us get that and put it in our exploit. Remember, this is Little Indian. So P64 and then we give its address. Next, send the payload and you receive the flag. Congrats, because we got the flag. This attack is commonly known as return to win or red to win in short. It is the easiest and the most commonly seen exploit challenge. So that's it for this video. Keep exploiting machines.